Okay, today we'll see in unit one. Today we'll see method study, objective, procedures, and its consideration. So let us see first of all what is ergonomics. As I told you, ergonomics came from the two Greek words ergon and nomos. Actually, I am giving a glimpse of my last lecture. We have seen that what is ergonomics. Ergonomics is derived from two Greek words, that is ergon and nomos. Ergon means work and nomos means laws. So the laws of work or the science of doing a particular work. And we have seen why we are studying this ergonomics, to remove the incompatibility between man and machine. Then we have seen ergonomics as a process. So we have seen that ergonomics as a process, we have analyzed the risk, then we have improvement in the plans, then we have measured the progress, and finally scale up the solutions for the same. Another thing, we have seen the benefits of ergonomics, that it lowers the cost, increases the productivity, and gives the better product quality, then the improved employees engagement, and finally the better safety of the employees. We have seen these things. Then we have seen what are the disciplines of ergonomics. So anthropometry, we have studied biomechanics, environmental physics, applied psychology, and social psychology we have seen. Then we have gone through what is work study, how it can be defined, and it was divided into two. First, we need to select a job. And another thing, but we have see what we have to see is we have to find the time, how much time this work will take for the completion. Then we have seen the objectives of work study. Objective is to analyze the particular job for the development of the new one, and to measure the work, how much time it is required. So these were the two basic objectives. Then we have seen that how productivity and work study are correlated, how work study benefits us in increasing the productivity or achieving the high productivity. So this was the part. So this much we have seen in the previous lecture. Today we'll see what is method study. Sometimes it is also called motion study also. So this method study is basically a systematic approach of analyzing a particular method of doing a particular job that includes human movement involved in it. So actually, this is the process of analyzing the methods involved in the work to increase the productivity or to achieve the higher productivity, thereby doing the work in a better way using less time and efforts. It is also sometimes known as work simplification, because we have to simplify the work, or we have to achieve the simplest work for performing the job. Okay, so we can see that method study helps actually in knowing two, three things. That is, how well our methods utilize the limited available resources like manpower, machines, materials, and money. Another thing, how our methods are physically actually applicable or dependent upon the production output of that particular unit. And the final thing is the quality of the output obtained by applying that particular method, because quality and cost is very important thing to achieve after production. So this was the basic idea behind the same. Another thing, now with this method we can determine the amount of input material. Input material means raw material. Raw material, how much time to be consumed, how much power to be consumed, how much money to be invested. So this type of considerations being a core one, where one has to attempt this input to reduce the consumption of the resources available. And finally, what we are going to get, we are going to get the better quality with less cost per unit through the proper utilization of that particular proposed method. And the newly designed method can decide the another cost and the quality of output which is being produced using the newly proposed method. Now, what is the scope of method study that we have to see? What is the scope exactly where it is being implemented? So at which corners we can get the scope of method study? So first of all, the layout of shop floor, the working areas or the working stations mana jahan machines ko build kiya gaya hai. So those are called working stations. Next is working conditions, that is the usage of ergonomics. Okay, we have discussed with the ergonomics, that is the relation between man and machine in the previous lecture, and we have also seen that how the incompatibility between the man and machine can be removed by using the concept of ergonomics. Okay, next one, third one is handling distances, that is the material movement that we have to see. Material has to move from a particular inventory area or the area between inventory and the machine, and in between material has to move till the workstation. Then comes the tooling and equipment used, there also we can apply. Then the quality standards to be achieved, where exactly quality standards to be achieved? At the inspection end. At the inspection end, as I told you, there are three bins mana jaise dabbe bins. So first bin is that quality, that product, that unit has achieved the quality. This is the finished product and it is the it has achieved the quality. And if they are rejecting, the rejections are of two types. First one is jo reject hua hai, that can be repaired and finally taken up in the accepted one. But this is the second bin, and the third bin is kuch bhi kar lo, isko hum finished mein achieve nahi kar sakte, so it has been finally scrapped. So there are two bins which comes into the accepted category, jo pehli bar mein accept ho jaye, dusra jo thoda rework hoke accept ho jaye. Theek hai? Next is operator or operations mein in achieving the production targets, there also we can apply. Then finally the materials to be used, there in the inventory end we can apply the same. Okay, so these were the scope of method study. Are you able to see the slide?
Yes sir.
Okay,
it is visible sir.
Okay, so what are the indicators showing the need of the method study? What are the indicators showing the need of the method study? Why, when and why and where exactly we feel that we need to apply the method study? First of all, let me discuss about bottleneck. What is bottleneck? Agar ek sequence flow mein kahi unit mein production ho raha hai, say 5 machines line se rakhi hain aur dusri machine is performing very slow ya kisi karan se ya kisi breakdown se, तो जो रॉ मटेरियल पहली मशीन पे प्रोसेस हुआ, फिर सेकेंड मशीन पे स्टक हुआ कुछ देर के लिए, तो तीसरी, चौथी और पांचवी मशीन आइडल है. सिमिलरली पांचवी मशीन के बाद जो इंस्पेक्शन डिपार्टमेंट है या वो एंड है, वो भी आइडल है. सो बॉटल नेक कहाँ पे हो रहा है, कहाँ पे चीजें भर रही है, जमा हो रही है? मशीन नंबर 2 पे. सो दिस इज द मीनिंग ऑफ बॉटल नेकनेस. सो वॉट आर द इंडिकेटर? इफ बॉटल नेक टेक्स प्लेस इन द प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम, then it relates to longer delivery dates and unbalanced workflow. Why it is unbalanced? Unbalanced kyunki pehli machine aur dusri machine pe to kaam ho pa raha hai aur dusri machine pe kaam stuck ho raha hai, teesri chauthi panchvi pe nahi ja pa raha, thereby inspection department bhi khali baitha hai kyunki they are waiting for the final finished product jo ki panchvi machine ke baad achieve hoga. Theek. Dusri cheez, ये डिलीवरी डेट्स लॉन्गर क्यों होंगी? क्योंकि सेकेंड मशीन का प्रॉब्लम जब तक सॉल्व नहीं होता, थर्ड फोर्थ फिफ्थ प्रोसेस हो नहीं पाएगी, फिनिश्ड गुड फाइनल अचीव नहीं हो पाएगा, तो यहाँ टाइम कंजम्पशन बढ़ जाएगा, जिस कारण से लॉन्गर डिलीवरी डेट्स मिलेंगी, है ना? डिलीवरी जो माल की होगी वो लेट होगी. अनदर पॉइंट इज underutilization of resources as idleness of the plant. So, ये भी bottlenecks के कारण हो सकता है, क्योंकि यहाँ हमने देखा था तीसरी चौथी पांचवी मशीन और इंस्पेक्शन डिपार्टमेंट के एंड पे दे आर आइडल फॉर अ पर्टिकुलर पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. सो सिमिलर टू दिस सिचुएशन मेनी अदर सिचुएशन कैन बी पॉसिबल जहां अंडर यूटिलाइजेशन हो सकता है रिसोर्सेज का. अंडर यूटिलाइजेशन का मतलब है कि रिसोर्सेज वी आर कैपेबल ऑफ डिलीवरिंग द और शेयरिंग द और प्रोवाइडिंग द रिसोर्सेज एलोकेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेज बट वी आर अनेबल टू यूटिलाइज इट. सो दिस इज अंडर यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेज. अनदर थिंग इज quality of the product can be affected by the poor worker morale, motivation, and this may lead to higher absenteeism or bahut zyada unavailability hoti hai laborers ki ya frequent absenteeism hota hai kyunki unka motivation ya morale kisi karan se kisi input se low hai to uska effect bhi product quality pe padta hai. aur baki jo upar ke do humne points dekhe the bottlenecks wale या अंडर यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेज का, इसके कारण भी मोरल और मोटिवेशन वर्कर का या ऑपरेटर का डाउन होता है. नाउ अनदर थिंग इज अगेन रिलेटेड टू एचआर पॉइंट व्हिच इज लाइक इनकंसिस्टेंट वेजेस और अर्निंग्स ऑफ अ वर्कर व्हिच इंडिकेट्स टाइम ऑफ रिव्यू फॉर द प्रोडक्शन टेक्निक्स एंड ऑल्सो रिव्यू फॉर द टाइम ऑफिस और एचआर ऑफिस एज वेल बिकॉज these are the main things. If a person is coming to a particular organization, obviously they are coming for earning the things, and if they are, these earning things are being delayed, then definitely it will affect the morale and motivation of the worker, and finally this may lead to the little bad or little lesser quality of a product. Okay, now what are the basic objectives that we have to see? What are the basic objectives of the method study? Basic objectives of method study, why we are doing it. Initially we have seen what are the scope. So we have seen what are the corners where we can implement, and then we have seen what are the indicators which tells us now this is the time we have to apply the method study. Then what are the objectives before starting the method study? Let us see. The objective of the method study is to get the improvement in the running processes and the procedures. Then the factory and the workplace layout improvement, because overall production quality is in the factory and the workplace itself. And the third one is the improvement in the design of plant and the equipments, because equipment maintenance is quite required. Otherwise, sometimes the breakdowns may come and the indicators of method study starts arriving. Okay, then comes the reduction of unnecessary fatigues and movements. As we have seen that in the method study definition, work study definition itself, that what we need to do, we need to analyze a better method. We need to analyze the better method, how to get a better method for a particular thing, for a particular how to get a better method over the existing method, and how to improve the work process, the quality, the cost part, the fatigue and the movement part of the laborers, workers or machine operators, and thereby we can increase the quality of improved material, machines, manpower, and also we can provide the better working conditions. So these were the objectives of method study. Then let us see, let us go to the steps which involves the method method study is being delivered. So first of all, first point is select. We need to select a job, particular job on which we have to study, do that method study. So we have to select the work to be studied. Second is record. So we need to record all the relevant facts about the current employed method or the present method on which production goes on. and then we have to think of a new one. And then after recording, we need to examine. What examine? The critical facts and the techniques being used for a particular method. The existing method hai, uske facts aur jo critical cheezein hui hain, jiske karan we are bound to apply the method study. So these things and the techniques being used for the particular method, that we have to see. Another thing is we need to develop. Now on this record and examine, we can develop the most practical, economic and effective method as per the current circumstances going on with the current method of work being done. So kya conditions hain unke liye koi practical, economic aur jyada effective method ko humko devise karna hai. Then we see the evaluate. Now we have to evaluate the alternative methods, because we are not only thinking of a single method to replace the existing method. We have n number of methods available with us, and then we have to finally arrive with a new improved method, because we have alternative options, and finally after study we have to arrive a new method. And then with new method, if new method is devised, then we have to define a new method, plan it, give it the procedure of the new method, layouts according to that new method. We have to rework on the layouts, the equipments, the working conditions, and then we need to install the improved method, plan the arrangement and implement the same. And further, after implementation, we need to maintain the new standard procedure with proper and controlled process. So these were the steps or procedures involved in the method study. Then we will see what are the selections of job, what are the selections of job for a particular method study. Let us see what are the selection, how the selection for the job in method study takes place. First of all, we know and we have discussed much of time that cost is quite an important aspect or the major criteria of selection a job and the process for the department to be to being done by the method analysis to carry out the same method analysis. A job has to be selected and the proposed method to be achieved, either it is one or sometimes it is two. So one or two results may arrive after selection of the job for a particular study. Here I am talking about what kind of job, the new method what we have finalized. So what we are going to get in the form of results is improvement in the quality with the lesser scrap. With the lesser scrap means third bin jiski main baat kar raha tha, rework ke baad bhi jisko hum finished mein nahi le sakte, that has to be reduced, because that includes cost. Agar main 10 item bana raha hu, 10 job pieces ko banane ke liye raw material laga raha hu, aur agar 9 ya 10 ke 10 achieve ho rahe hain, to mere paas ya to zero scrap hai ya ek scrap hai. But if it happens like 10 mein 4 scrap ho rahe hain aur 6 finish ja rahe hain, then it includes cost. Even selected mein bhi jo second bin hai jisme mujhe rework karna pad raha hai, so there I am using a separate process cost, separate labor cost, separate time of production. So many separate things we are deploying there, so it also includes cost. Lekin us cost ko include karne ke baad bhi agar wo finish da raha hai, so that is acceptable. But sometimes it happens like it is not even repairable, so it is going totally in waste. तो उसमें हमारा रॉ मटेरियल का कॉस्ट भी गया, प्रोडक्शन का कॉस्ट भी गया, और लेबर कॉस्ट भी गया, टाइम कॉस्ट भी गया, प्रोसेस कॉस्ट भी गया, व्हाटएवर कॉस्टिंग वी हैव दैट इज गॉन इन वेस्ट. सो दैट हैज टू बी रिड्यूस्ड विद इंप्रूव्ड क्वालिटी ऑफ द फिनिश्ड गुड्स. देन कम्स द इंक्रीज्ड प्रोडक्शन थ्रू बेटर यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेज. यस, मेथड स्टडी गिव्स यू द क्लियर पिक्चर अबाउट द utilization of better utilization of the resources, and thereby you can increase the production as well. And finally, the elimination of unnecessary operation and movements. Yes, it is method study gives you the reduction in unnecessary movement and operations, movement of the material also, movement of the resources also, movement of the manpower also or operator also, and the machine operations also. So this really helps in increasing the productivity. And finally, you'll get the improved layout to the smooth flow of material. That is material, this means the raw material and the finished goods, and the in-between requirement. And finally, we'll get the balanced production, smooth continuous flow. And last but not the least, we'll get the improved working condition for the operators and the laborers. Okay. Now, let us see the considerations of selection of the method study. Considerations for the methods of consideration for the selection of the method study. We majorly devise three criteria for this. One is economic aspect, another is technical aspect, and third is human aspect. Economic aspect is the first one. We need to implement the cost criteria, as I told you earlier. Then we'll go for the technical aspects like production, raw material, processes, scrap, and all the cost calculations. Then we'll go for the human aspect, because that human power or the manpower is quite required in the form of operator and the labor. So we'll go one by one, we'll go through the aspects. First one is economic aspect. Now, the economic aspect is like it really involves in the method study in the form of cost and time. And if insufficient return arrives, or not attended, the sufficient returns not attended, the whole exercise of devising a new method or go on waste, or even in the case of existing method, it go on waste. Thus, the money spent should be justified by savings from the particular method, either being implemented or being proposed a new one. So the following guidelines has to be taken care of while selecting a job. First of all, the bottlenecks should not appear during the production operations. Second one is the operations that involves the excessive labor involvement or movement. Third is operations producing a lot of scraps and defects. That includes cost, as I discussed with you in the previous slide. Then comes the operations which is having poor utilization of resources. And sometimes we can say underutilization of resources, and sometimes it goes on overutilizations as well. Raw material ka overutilization ho gaya agar scrap badh gaya to wo part bhi hai. Then backtracking of material and excessive movement of materials, that is the same thing, overutilization of materials. But backtracking comes into picture, how much we have shoot, what is the status of raw material, how much we have turned up in the finished one, and how much it is scrapped, and how much it is gone for rework. That is backtracking. That is called backtracking exactly. Then comes the technical aspect. So the method study man exactly, the person behind this method study is an industrial engineer or a planning engineer. So that method study man should be careful enough, to select a job in which he has the technical knowledge and expertise. A person selecting a job in his area of expertise is going to do the full justice. Otherwise the new entrant cannot get into. So some other factors are there which favors the technical aspect. One is job having a consistent quality, operations which generates the lot of scraps, and the frequent complaints from the worker regarding the job. So these were the things, and finally comes the human consideration. The human consideration is like method study means a change which is going to affect the full job operations over the presently done method. And if it is not fully accepted by the workers and the unions, then human consideration comes and plays a very important role in it. There are some situations where exactly human aspect is very of bigger importance, or it management should give or HR should give the due importance to these situations. Like if the workers are complaining about the unnecessary or tiring work, then, or if more frequency of accidents takes place, or inconsistency of earning takes place. So these are the thing when which one has to see actually. So this was the part for today's lecture. Thank you. If you have any doubt, you can ask me now.